This is what essentially, broadly speaking, the four steps would be: the discovery, the long list, the short list, and then the selection. Discovery is the need assessment. When I spoke about, you know, the company, its culture, how the company functions, what are the different kinds of requirements, that's what we are talking about as need assessment. For your current campaign, in short term and long term, what are the different kind of services you would require? You need to understand that at your end first. Then you get, and you have to take into account as to what are your requirements going to be in terms of collateral, in terms of creativity, in terms of cost. Taking those into account, you are in a good position to understand that, yes, this is what my requirement is. Then you get into long listing. Here you understand the agency, that okay, if this is my requirement, these are the kind of agencies I would require. So find out in the market that this kind of agencies, who are there, understand, are you looking at geographical proximity? Because in today's technology world, it's not really important that the agency has to be next door. The agency has to be competent in what they are promising to do for you. So find those factors: the cost factor, the proximity factor, the resources they have, the scale of your campaign, the resources that are available with the agency. So do and find out the different kind of agencies that you require. Make a long list of agency names that would fit those kind of requirements, who would be able to give you those services. Once you have figured these two out, then you make a short list, because obviously you do not have the time, money, resources to meet all of them. You short list based on your conversation with them, or based on their website, based on what they have already done in the market. Make a short list of companies who you think can give the services that you require, and meet them. Because agency client relation is something which in today's scenario especially is not something that can be just, let's choose this agency. No, you really have to understand what is the philosophy of that agency. Does it fit with yours? Can their team and our team work hand in hand in the near future? That's where you do shortlisting. We can also call it as the chemistry meet. Because if you do not get along, if you do not like the team that you're working with, there's no way that the result is going to come out good. So this is the time to really understand, are we getting along, our team, their team, are we on the same page? Then you put them into 1, 2, 3 listing. And then you get into selection. You select and finalize. A lot of terms, when we start, my years in advertising have taught that even if you think that, okay, this is a fantastic match, always think of the various scenarios that can come in. Think of the exit clause. Discuss money clearly and properly. Discuss the various terms. Discuss when is a project successful? What are the criteria that the client has? You as an agency might have a different set of understanding that, okay, this project is successful, but the client may have a different idea of when to call a project successful. So understand those things. What are the delivery formats? What are the timelines? Based on that, have your selection. Once you have selected, that's just the start of the journey. The process, the working process, the day in, day out is a different ball game altogether. I mean, all the young people out there would know that dating is fun. But when you get married and when you live with the person 24/7, it's a completely different scenario altogether. Agency client relation is something like that. I mean, you start with a honeymoon period. The idea is to extend the comfort level over time period, because the teams are working together. There are bound to be differences. How do we minimize that? How do we have a process to address the disagreements? So the starting point is the brief note, and it is a very, very critical piece of document, which in my experience, not all clients give it that much importance. But I would urge all you marketing professionals out there that brief note gives a lot of clarity to the entire campaign. And when you sit to write it, it also brings a lot of clarity to yourself. And when you are clear, you can really manage the other end well. It is kind of the real important starting point for anything. Set the expectations. What are the KPIs? When, which person is supposed to do what? When do you, as I said, call a project successful? What are the different key performing, at which point do you say that, okay, now we go to the next step? So these are the expectation setting things that that is a very critical point in any agency client relationship. Communication flow, of course. If you do not communicate and the client thinks that I have done my part and the agency thinks I have done my part, that's not something that's going to work out. Keep meeting, schedule calls, send reports, proactively understand what's the next thing to do. At times even try to prejudge before the client sends his requirement that what could be the next thing that the client would require. That way an agency is far more prepared to handle the client. So these are certain things. When you have the communication flow, when you have set expectations, when you have defined what you expect from them, these things flow naturally. Keep meeting regularly for performance review. A lot of things unveil that time. A lot of things are set at peace that, okay, this is done. This is done. This needs work. This is not done. How do we complete this in the next quarter or whatever timelines you set?